Because you see, once upon a time, I stood stone-like at midnight, suspended in my masquerade. I combed my hair, it looked just right, and commanded the night brigade. Hey! I was open to pain and crossed by rain. I walked on a crooked crutch. I strode on low to fall out soul. Came out with my soul untouched. I hear them applauding, wrapped the crowd. When they said, sit down, I stood up. Ooh, oh, winner, yeah. Now the flag of piracy flew from my mast. My sails were set wing to wing. I had a jukebox graduate for first mate. She couldn't sail, but she sure could sing. Why push B-52? Bombed her with the blues. Put my gear shed stubborn on stand. I broke all the rules straight my old day school. Never once gave thought to man. Now there I was. I was still in high school, but I wasn't doing too good. I was doing bad in my studies, and they sent me down to see the guidance counselor. And I walked in and he said, Mr. Springsteen, what seems to be your problem? So I said, well, sir, like you see, I don't have any interest in anything. I don't know what I want to do with myself. I don't care what's going on around me. I ain't got any faith. I don't have any hope in anything. I don't have any close interpersonal relationship with a member of the opposite sex. I don't have a... He said, no, that's too big a problem. You better go home and talk to your folks about it. So I went home and I went in the kitchen and my pop was in there. I said, Pop, man, I got sent home from school. I've been in a lot of trouble lately and I really got to talk to you about something. I don't know what's going to happen with me. I don't have any interest in anything. I daydream in class all the time. And I don't have any faith in anything in myself. I don't have any hope in anything. And he said, will you get me another beer out of the icebox? So that was it. I decided I was going to do myself in. I was going to end it all. I was going to say goodbye, cruel world. Yeah. So I got out and I hitchhiked down to Asbury Park. I was gonna jump in the ocean and drown myself. I was sitting there on the boardwalk, contemplating the water temperature. Then all of a sudden, in the distance, this big handsome dude came walking by. He kind of sat down next to me, his started saying my prayers. And we kind of got talking. And I was telling him all about my problem. And he started telling me all about his problem. And we cried on each other's shoulder for a while. But we decided that we'd make a good team, and we became partners. That's right, that's right, that's right, that's right. And Clarence, he said that he knew a gypsy lady that could help us out with our troubles. So over to the gypsy we went. It was late at night. The boardwalk was deserted. We walked in. We paid our $250 each. I had to loan clients just $250. And she looked into the crystal ball and she said, "You boys are in a lot of trouble." Paid another $250. I didn't get it back yet either. And we looked, she looked into the crystal ball and then she said, "You boys are gonna go on a real long trip. You're gonna seek out new forms of life. You're gonna explore new worlds. You're gonna go where no men have ever gone before and stay twice as long and have a lot of fun doing it too." And she gave us a map to the secret of the world, and she said if we followed that map at midnight, we'd find the answers to all our troubles. So that night we got in Clarence's Oldsmobile and we started driving south down Route 9. South through the rain, down through Lakewood, down through Freehold, down through Tom's River. And a hurricane hit and then a tornado blew across the highway and then a blizzard hit. And then a heat wave broke. And then the roof flew off the car. And then we got two flat tires. And then the fenders flew off. And then the engine block cracked. And then the carburetor went. And then the windows flew out. And then the radio broke. What that's like. But there we were on the side of this dark dirt road, and according to the map, what we were looking for was just on the other side of those woods. So into the forest we went. It was spooky in there. There were sounds coming from all over the place. Sounded like werewolves. Sounded like homicidal cows. Sounded like mad dogs barking. Sounded like the Jersey Devil out there. Now, big man, I ain't never heard of no killer beasts like in New Jersey or nothing. Did you? No. I heard of like killer hamburgers, but I didn't know killer beasts, man. But I think we're safe out here, don't we? Yeah. We all right? Well, I think I hear something behind us. Clarence.
Clarence, oh Clarence.
And all of a sudden, up behind us came these two big man-eating bears. But instead of jumping on us and making us their dinner, they were acting kind of friendly. And they said that they weren't mean, but that they were just lonely. And that they'd been out here in the woods for a long time by themselves after they escaped from the circus because they get tired of living in them cages. And they say that if we'd be their friends, that they'd help us find what we were looking for. And so back into the forest we went. And all of a sudden, the clouds pulled away from the moon. And there in a clearing, we saw the answer to our quest. Goodbye to the bears for the last time. And as we stood there in the moonlight, we knew that everything was gonna be all right. Because when we touched, vacations in the stratosphere. You know it's really hard to hold your breath. That's where I lost everything I ever loved to fear. I was the cosmic cat. My feet, they finally took root in the earth. I got me a nice little place in the stars. I swear I found the key to the universe. The engine of an old boxcar. We hit it, the cloud and wrath of the cloud. Bye-bye, New Jersey. We were